Hi all. I wanted to share with you this beautiful insight that's inspired by an article by Rachelle Noemi Remen. I'll post the link in the description. It's about the difference between fixing, helping, and serving. Now, if I'm to hear the words, "How may I fix you?" right away it feels and sounds off. First of all, it's very objectifying, and secondly, it implies that I'm broken. Now, if I'm to hear the words, "How may I help you?" certainly sounds and feels better. Certainly feels very good to say it, like I have something to give somebody. Yet if you go deep into the experience, it does point to a power-based dichotomy between the helper and the helpless, that this one is somehow more powerful and better and stronger, whatever it might be. And it could inadvertently be doing some harm in terms of self-esteem, self-worth, and self-confidence. Now, if I'm to hear the words, "How may I serve you?" suddenly it feels entirely different. Even to say it, it just feels so deeply connected. We only serve things that we really appreciate and really value. And to hear the words, "How may I serve you?" suddenly it has an empowering and uplifting quality to it. You know, even with inanimate objects, I could fix a machine, or I could serve that machine in functioning better. So much more with animate living beings. My daughter, for example, she's a young baby. I could help her eat, or I could serve her in that I'm fully recognizing her own integrity and her own belonging to the wholeness of life, the same thing that I'm a part of. And as equals, there's somehow an ability to use some knack and talent to serve this other being and recognizing that person's completeness and beauty. So it's a much deeper connection, and it's much deeper in terms of value and recognition and appreciation, to the point of even reverence of how amazing it is to serve this beautiful being. Also, with my yoga practice, it's not a practice to fix this body. It's not a practice to even help this body. This body is very capable. It's much more a recognition of how inherently wise and intelligent this body is. It's such a profound gift, and it's a privilege to look after it, and to share and to support and serve it in a way that it functions at its full thrivability. Also with the mind, I could meditate not to fix anything. It's perfectly fine. It's much more about serving this mind and allowing it to achieve this condition that is so peaceful and calm and with just profound presence. So it's much more in service of this beautiful faculty. And also when we practice from this place, it has a way of reducing, diminishing, and even dissolving the ego that wants to claim everything, that shouting, screaming mind, suddenly falls back in this place of service. Just like my eyes are in service of seeing, my ears are in service of hearing, and so on, the thinking faculty now is in service of anything that's arising in the present moment. So it's not serving me or serving you or serving this cause or that cause. It's just serving whatever happens to be arising right here and now, in service of that. Something else that's a big difference between helping and serving is sometimes when we're helping, it has a depleting, like a tiring quality. Because I'm helping from me to that, from me to that. Now, when we tap into serving, it's entirely different. You can call it life or grace or whatever. Something is flowing through us, and all our unique knacks and talents and attributes are manifesting in service of what's arising, and which is just a privilege to witness and experience. And when we witness and experience in that way, the only suitable response is deep gratefulness. So, in the spirit of gratitude and service, I hope and wish that this video was of service for you. Much love.